Join us as Ross Anderson and Pete Lothringer of Marshall jazz up the town at Central High School in Slayton.
My dad was a great fan of Dixieland jazz and had a large collection of Dixieland records. Pete Fountain, the Dukes of Dixieland, Louis Armstrong. Al heard all the old New Orleans players, many more than that, too.
Take a blue horn, New Orleans bar. You take a stick with a lick. Take a bone. Hold the phone. Take a spot, cool and hot. Now you have jazz, 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 jazz. A little dog song.
Well, I started playing clarinet in the first place when I was 9 years old. And then when I was 13, I was a freshman in high school, and the band director said, well, we have a tenor saxophone at the school, and if you can learn to play it, you can be in the jazz band. So I brought the tenor home, tenor saxophone, and according to my mom, I sat down and played for 8 hours without stop. Once I learned to play that, then I, you know, began to think that I would like to be able to play some of the jazz like I was hearing on the records. So that was really the start of it.
I got interested in jazz music fairly early in my career. Songs in a cover band, a Duke Ellington tune or something, and it was quite a bit different than the rock and country I was more familiar with at the time. And over the years, just investigated more and more, and eventually, after meeting my partner here in Marshall, Ross Anderson, started really learning a lot of the tunes and delving into it much more deeply. So it was a very long, decades-long kind of slow immersion in jazz. Met up with Ross, and he's a real jazz musician. He's been doing it since he was a kid, and so I just took that as an opportunity to really, really learn about it. And
Pete is an extraordinary player. He covers, you know, parts that would normally be played by a bass, and covers the chords that would be played by a piano, and then also, of course, there's the rhythm aspect of it. So you need the right guitar player to do that.
When people show up just to hear you play your music, then it's you play much better because there's an energy there. They appreciate it too, and if it goes well, they, you know, some of them are going to pick up on that, and that's kind of what makes it all worthwhile in the end, I think.
In jazz, you get to create the stuff that you want to play, so that's really what I like the most about it.